Hello students, welcome to the class. Today we are going to discuss about the receptor as drug targets. Receptors as drug targets. Before that, we have to remember certain points which are discussed yesterday, and those are: yesterday we discussed about the drug enzyme interaction. That means how an enzyme is influenced by drug. How an enzyme is influenced by drug. In that, this influence is of two types. One is competitive inhibition. Another one is attacking the allosteric sites. In case of competitive inhibition, drug competitively occupies the enzyme's active site, so that this drug is blocking the active site of the enzyme. Like that, working drugs are one type. Another type of drugs are drugs which attacks the allosteric site. When drugs attacks the allosteric site, active site of the enzyme changes, the shape of the active site of the enzyme changes. When the shape of the active site of enzyme changes, the natural chemical is not going to attack the active site of the enzyme. That is the second type. Now what we are discussing is receptor as drug targets. So what are these receptors? First we have to identify known these receptors. Receptors are the proteins. Every cell contains receptor proteins on its surface. These receptor proteins have some active sites. Okay? Receptors are the proteins. Every cell contains some receptor proteins embedded within the cell. These receptor proteins are projected outside of the cell. These receptor proteins have some active sites. Okay? These receptor proteins going to attack with messenger chemicals. What are these messenger chemicals? What is this message carrying chemicals? Messages in our body transfers from one neuron to another neuron, and from a neuron to muscle cell transfer in the form of chemicals. So these messages are always in the form of chemicals. Okay? From neuron to neuron, message is transferred in the form of chemicals. From neuron to muscle, message is transferred in the form of chemical. Okay? So if you want to move your hand like this, then your brain sends a signal. Those signals are transferred from our brain to these muscle tissues, to the muscles, in the form of chemicals. These signals are transferred in the form of chemicals. So those are the chemical messages. Those are the chemical messengers. Okay, from neuron to neuron and from neuron to muscles, messages are transferred in the form of chemicals. These messages attacks the receptor proteins. These messages attacks the receptor proteins. So, in our textbook, these receptor proteins are shown like this. So here I am showing a cell, and this is the cell outer membrane. This is the cell outer membrane. In this outer membrane of this cell, this is the receptor protein. This is the chemical messenger. This is the chemical messenger. So messages are transferred from neuron to neuron, or from neuron to a cell, or from neuron to an muscles transferred in the form of chemicals. This is the chemical messenger. This is a chemical. If this chemical, if attacks this active site, this is the active site, receptor protein. This is the receptor protein part of the cell. If this chemical attacks this site, then it gives the signal, then it shows some information to the cell. That information is transferred into the cell. If this chemical is not attacking at this place, this cell will not get any kind of information. So if this chemical attacks here, if this chemical just touches this receptor protein, then this cell get some kind of message. If this chemical does not attack this receptor protein, this cell does not get any kind of message. So that all in our body, different chemicals are there. If the chemical touches the receptor protein, we will get some messages into the cell. When this chemical attacks this receptor protein, this receptor protein going to change its shape, so that other chemical will not going to attack at this place. Okay? After receiving the message, again get its shape like this. Like these receptor proteins, there are so many receptor proteins are present in the cells. When these chemicals attaches to these receptor proteins, it gives some information. That attachment will give the some information to the cell. If this chemical is not attaching the receptor protein, it will not show any kind of message. Okay? If this chemical attaches this protein, it will give some information to the cell, so that the cell will going to respond. Now, this is the mechanism how cells will get the messages from neurons to muscles, and from neuron to neuron. Like this, messages are going to transfer. Now here we are going to discuss about how these receptors and drugs going to interact with each other, are going to interact with each other. Here we have to discuss two different cases. One is, we are manufacturing a drug that is going to interact before this chemical and attacks the receptor. So I manufactured a chemical which first attacks the receptor site before this chemical information. So that if this chemical reaches the receptor site, this receptor site already occupied by the drug what we are injected to the body. So this cell will not going to get any kind of message. Such kind of drugs are known as antagonists. So what are antagonist drugs? Drugs which are bind the receptor sites, which are bind the receptor proteins and inhibit the natural function of these cells, these receptor proteins. Bind to receptor protein. Bind to receptor protein and inhibit natural function. Natural function. These kind of drugs are called antagonist drugs. These antagonist drugs are required when we have to inhibit the natural processes. When we have to inhibit the natural process. For example, we have some injury. Due to that injury, you are feeling some pain. So what you will do? First we have to identify how the pain sensation we are processing. So that pain sensation, that swelling, the redness is due to the histamines. Wherever we are getting the injury, at those places histamines are released. Histamines are the derivatives of amino acids. Wherever these histamines are releasing, there are these histamines are accumulating. There we can see redness. There we can see the swelling. What these histamines will do? These histamines are the chemicals. These histamines going to attach the receptor protein. So the receptor protein will send a signal to the cell. So you are injured. So feel the pain. That signal is processed by our brain. If you stop the attachment of this chemical, that means histamine, into this receptor protein, then what happens? You are not feel any kind of pain. So simply, if you stop the attachment of this histamine with some chemical, into the attachment of receptor protein, these cells will not going to receive the pain sensations. Okay, when pain is there, wound is there, injury is there, but you are not going to feel the pain. So in such cases, these antagonist drugs are useful. That means these antagonist drugs bind to receptor proteins, and inhibit the natural functions. Or when there is an injury is there, our natural function is pain is our natural reaction. So if you stop that natural reaction, what you have to do? You have to competitively block this receptor protein. If you stop this occupying the receptor protein by the histamines, then you are not going to feel the pain. So for that, different chemicals are there, painkillers, what we are called, simple terms are painkillers. What these painkillers will do? These painkillers will do it to occupy the receptor proteins. But when this painkiller occupy the receptor proteins, you are not getting the signals. When you are not getting the signals, you are not feeling the pain. But injury is there. So those kind of drugs are antagonist drugs. Second type of drugs are agonist drugs. These agonist drugs mimics the natural messenger actions. So these are the duplicate chemicals. Behaves like natural chemicals. So if this natural chemical is going to attack this site, we feel something, we feel some sensations. But this natural chemical production is not there in our body. So in such cases, what happens? You are not going to receive the message into the cell. In such such cases, we are going to manufacture some drugs which behaves like natural messengers, but they are not the natural messengers, but they are not the real ones. We are creating some duplicate one. This duplicate also behaving like natural. So this duplicate one going to attack the receptor. When receptor feels that the real one is attacking this one, so it sends the signals to the cell to respond. Such kind of drugs are known as the agonist drugs. So agonist drugs are which mimics the natural messenger. These agonist drugs are useful when lack of natural messengers are there. If our body is not producing enough natural messengers, then you have to give the natural messengers to our body to respond. It is very difficult to prepare the natural messenger, hence we are going to that we are going to give this natural messenger like a chemical to our body. So that one also we have the same way. So those kind of drugs are known as the agonist drugs. So like this drug is going to interact with the receptor. So generally what happens? Messages from neuron to neuron or neuron to muscles transfers in the form of chemicals. These are called chemical messengers. I have shown these receptor proteins and the chemical messenger like this. Every cell contains large number of receptor proteins. When these chemical messengers attach to this receptor protein, it sends some signal to our cells. If this chemical does not attach to the receptor protein, we will not get any kind of signals into our cells. Basing on that, we are preparing drugs. These drugs are of two types, antagonist drugs and agonist drugs. Antagonist drugs are the drugs which binds to the receptor site before this chemical is attached. So what happens? The signal will generate. So otherwise the signal before this chemical is going to attach, this receptor protein is occupies the receptor, this chemical will be drug going to occupy the receptor protein. So if real chemical will come to this surface, it is not going to attach, this one is already blocked, so that this cell will not get any kind of message. So these kind of drugs are used when there is need to inhibit the natural function, when there is need to stop the natural function. Next type of drugs are agonist drugs. These agonist drugs mimics the natural messenger. Means they behave like real messenger. These drugs are required when natural messenger production is less in our body. So when you give that drug, this drug behaves like natural messenger and occupies the receptor sites. So like that, receptors and drugs are going to interact. This is about the receptor drug interactions. The next topic we are going to discuss is different types of drugs means medicines. When these medicines are useful and what are their effects? First one is antacids. So what are these antacids? Chemicals which removes excess of acid present in our stomach. And increases the pH value are known as the antacids. Antacids are the chemicals which removes excess of acid present in our body and increases the pH value. Those are the antacids. Generally used antacids are sodium bicarbonate, sodium hydrogen carbonate, and metal hydroxide. Like magnesium hydroxide and aluminium hydroxide. Generally used antacids are sodium bicarbonate, metal hydroxide like magnesium hydroxide and aluminium hydroxide. These are the generally using antacids. What about the sodium bicarbonate? If you take small amount of excess of sodium bicarbonate, it increases the alkalinity. It increases the basic nature in our stomach, which causes vomitings and other side effects. So using sodium bicarbonate requires extreme precautions as an antacid. So it is not preferable because a small amount of excess of sodium bicarbonate will cause the side effects, will cause the increasing of alkalinity in our stomach again, which produces some other side effects. So it is not preferable, but we can use this sodium bicarbonate as an antacid. Olden days, sodium bicarbonate is used. Nowadays we are using metal hydroxide like magnesium hydroxide and aluminium hydroxide as antacids because these metal hydroxides are insoluble, in water. Very small amount of metal hydroxide is going to soluble. That one only neutralizes the acid. The remaining thing is not going to soluble. It remains as it is. So for example, in gelsin, we use the gelsin syrup. That is, gelsin contains these things, metal hydroxides, magnesium hydroxide, aluminium hydroxide, all these metal hydroxide. Gelsin contains these metal hydroxides. So look at here. Generally what happens is histamines are the chemicals, histamines are the chemicals which are the derivatives of amino acid, which are the derivative of histidine amino acid. This is the derivative of histidine amino acid. This is the histamine. When this histamine attaches the receptor sites in our stomach, it releases the pepsin and HCl for the digestion process. When histamine attaches the receptor site present in our stomach, it activates the cells to release the pepsin, trypsin and HCl. HCl means the acid will be released as H+ ions and H+ into our stomach. So that when we take the food, all the proteins present in that food is going to digestion. That is the process generally takes place. But sometimes what happens is, our cells will release excess of HCl. So when excess of HCl releases into our stomach, acidity will create. Due to this acidity, long termly we will get the ulcers. So long term, due to acidity, ulcers occurs. To avoid that thing, scientists manufactured a drug and medicine. It is called cimetidine. This cimetidine, if taken before the food, before 15 minutes going to food, if cimetidine tablets are taken, these cimetidine tablets preferentially attacks the receptor sites. Present in our stomach. When these cimetidine chemicals are binded with the receptor cells, the chemical messages is going to stop. When chemical messages is not getting by our cells is not releases the this HCl. When HCl is not releasing too excessively, then slowly this acidity will diminish. Okay, the first chemical after this metal hydroxide. They simply neutralize the excess of acid present in our stomach. What cimetidine will do? Cimetidine tries to stop the release of HCl. So the cimetidine stops the release of HCl. This metal hydroxide neutralizes the release of HCl. Okay, so which one is better one? Which one is advanced one? Cimetidine is advanced one because it is stopping the release of HCl itself. What this gelsinol will do? Will neutralize the excess of acid. So this cimetidine is used extensively throughout the world until another medicine is manufactured, and that one is rantidine. In market we will get this rantidine in the name of Zintac, Rantac, like that. So Zintac tablets, you know the Zintac tablets, so many people are using this Zintac, Rantac. So all these are the chemicals which behaves like cimetidine. Okay, cimetidine is the first chemical which is used to stop the release of excess of acid in our stomach. So this is about antacid. Next we have to discuss about antihistamine. So what are these antihistamines? First we have to discuss about histamines. Histamines are the derivatives of histidine amino acid. These histamines present all the cells in our body. All cells contains histamines. All cells in our body contains the histamines. These histamines causes the allergic actions. Like inflammation, asthma, itching, redness of the skin, eye itching, nasal secretion, all these are due to histamines. They are already present in our body, but when their concentration somewhat increases due to external factors, we feel its consequences, like allergic actions. These allergic actions are different types. Some people, these allergic actions, if something insect bite is there, what we feel? We feel itching, redness, inflammation of the skin. All these are the natural actions of histamines. So when bite occurs, these histamines will release to stop the foreign chemicals entering foreign chemicals into our body. So it is trying to throw the foreign chemicals from our body. So the control at one, excess of histamines are released. Due to that excess of histamine, we feel this allergic action, redness, itching, inflammation of the skin, and redness in the eyes, irritation, nasal secretion. When you get the cold, what happens? Liquids will come from our nose. That one also due to the histamines. So if you stop the natural action of these histamines, you can stop the all these allergic actions also. You can stop the all these allergic actions if you stop the natural action of histamine. If you stop the binding of these histamines to the receptor cells, then allergic actions also stops down. For that, we have so many drugs are there, we have so many medicines are there. Some of the medicines are bromophenamine, chlorophenamine. These bromophenamine and chlorophenamine generally used for cold. So when you get cold, if you ask, when you take the syrup, look at the syrup, what is the composition of syrup? It contains bromophenamine and chlorophenamine. These bromophenamine and chlorophenamine relieves the fluids secretion, relieves our symptoms of flu, symptoms of cold. And another type of this antihistamines are terfenadine. This terfenadine will be available in the form of Seldel. This Seldel also is an antihistamine. Another most important one is Benadryl. Benadryl, sir, this one also used for cold. This ventrinin also is a medicine used as an antihistamine. So this is about antihistamine. We will discuss some more drugs in the next class. For this class, it is enough. Thank you.